Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_004_DIAB_M where you save it. You can also download this file on the website. Click the File tab and hover the mouse cursor to Save As Project. This brings the save project as dialog box. Name this file to 00_005_DIAB_M and click the save button. We'll continue this tutorial where we start from the previous tutorial. Now select this wall, select this dimension. When you select this dimension, you can add witness line or reduce a witness line. Now we are going to add a witness line to this dimension. Click the edit witness line command. Now if I click the face of this wall, Revit remove one witness line. So I'm going to click this face to add a witness line and this face to add another witness line. Click in an empty area to terminate the edit witness line command. Click the modify button. Now select this wall and change this value to 5550. Press enter. Zoom in into this area, click on this bubble and extend it to this wall. Make sure that the angle reaches 90 degrees. Zoom out, select this wall and make sure that the distance, the temporal dimension, say 3000. With the all seal selected, select the grid similar command. Hover the mouse cursor. When you see the temporal alignment from the center of the previous wall, click. Move the mouse cursor into this direction. Make sure that the angle reaches 45 degrees and click. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and make sure that the mouse cursor reaches 35 degrees. Click. Move the mouse cursor up this direction, click to draw another 45 degrees, then move the mouse cursor at the vertical direction, make sure that the angle read 90 degrees, and click the modify button to get out of the wall command. Now go to the modify tab, select the trim extend to corner and select this wall. Zoom in and select this wall, select this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Select this wall and change this value to 4800. Press enter. Select this wall and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this wall again, change this value to 4200 millimeter. Press enter. With the wall still select, click the flip arrow to flip it to the outside. With the wall still selected, go to the grid panel and select grid similar. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Now go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Draw a dimension from the face of this wall to the face of this wall. Click to place a dimension. Click the modify button. Select this wall and change this value to 3750. Press enter. Now go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner button. Select this wall and this wall, this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Select this wall. Click the witness, flip the arrow to the right direction. Select this wall to check that the wall went in the right direction. Now select this wall again. Click this witness line to move it to the core face of this wall. Change the value to 2100 millimeter. Press enter. Click outside to deselect the object. Zoom out. Select the trim extend single element and click the face of this wall. Click to trim this wall. Click the modify button. Select this wall and change its dimension to 7200 mm. Press enter. Go to the modify panel and select trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall. Select the trim extend single element. Select the face of this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Select the trim extend single element. Select this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Right click the wall and select grid similar. Start a wall from this point. Move when you see the temporal dimension says approximately like 900. Click, move up, click, move to the left, click, and move down, click to complete. Click the modify button. Now select this wall and move the witness line of the dimension to this wall and change this value to 4800 mm. Press enter. Select this wall, move this value to the face, to the core face of this wall, change this value to 550 mm. Press enter. With the wall still selected, select the grid similar command. Draw another wall from this point to this point. Flip the wall, this arrow outside. Click the modify button. Go to the modify panel and select the split element. Click this wall to split the wall and click the modify button. Right click the wall, select grid similar. Draw another wall from this point to this point. Click the modify button. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall, 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 this wall. Click the modify button. Now select this wall and change the value to 4800. Press enter. Select this wall. Click the witness line of the temporal dimension and add this witness line to this face. Click the value and change it to 6300 mm. Press enter. Select this wall, change its value to 1850 mm. Press enter. Select this wall, move the witness line to the face of this wall, to the core face of this wall, and change this value to 2550 mm. Press enter. Select this wall, move the witness line to the face of this wall and move this witness line to the core face of this wall. Change this value to 2550 mm. Press enter. With the wall still, click the flip arrow to flip it in the other direction. With the wall selected, select grid similar. Draw a wall from this point to this point to this point. Click the modify button. Right click this wall, select this wall. Now go to the quick access toolbar and select the measure command. Click on the face of this wall to the face. Zoom in and click the face of this wall. Make sure that the value is 1200 mm. If not, change that value. Now right click the wall and select create similar. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Trim this to this, this to this. Click the modify button. Now select this wall and change this input to 1050 mm. Press enter. Select this wall, click the witness line to this face and change the input to 1200 mm. Press enter. Flip the wall into the other direction. Zoom out Select the trim extend to corner. Trim this wall to this wall. Click the modify button. Select this wall to see that it's 4800 mm. Now select this wall also and make sure that it's 6300 mm. Select this wall and move the witness line to the core face of this wall. Change the value to 1850 mm. Press enter. Select this wall. Change this value to 675 mm. Press enter. Select this wall. Now go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Select this face, this face, this face, this face, this face, and this face. Click to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Select this wall. Change the value to 675. Press enter. Select this. Change this value to 675. Press enter. Select this. Change this value to 2550 mm. Press enter. Select this wall and change the value to 2000 mm. Click outside to end the command. Right click this reference plane and select create similar. Draw a reference plane from this point to this point. Draw another one from this point to this point. Click the modify button. Select the align dimension command in the measure panel. Select the face of this wall and the face of this wall and select this reference plane. Move the mouse cursor down and click to place the dimension. Click the EQ button. Click the modify button. Select the dimension and select. Click the down arrow next to equal display and select value to display the value. Now select the dimension command. Select the reference plane and change the value to 1800 mm. With the reference plane still selected, select the grid similar command and change the offset distance to 150 mm. Press enter. Select the pick line button and offset this reference plane up. Click the modify button. Select the reference plane again and select grid similar. Click the pick line button in the draw panel and change the offset distance to 1500 mm. Press enter. Offset this line up. Press the modify button. Right click this wall, select grid similar. The circumscribe polygon option in the draw panel and change the number of side to 8. The wall location change to core face exterior. Click at the intersection of this reference plane and move your mouse cursor down. Click to this reference plane to complete the command. Because this wall overlaps with this other wall, Revit complete. Now click the modify button. Place your mouse cursor into this area, click and use a window selection to select the other wall and hit delete on your keyboard to remove it. Do the same thing at this other side, hit delete and remove it. Select this wall, hold down the control key, select this wall and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the trim extend to corner, select this wall and this wall, this wall and this wall. Click the modify button, select the zoom out, select the trim extend to corner again, select this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Now select this wall and flip it outside. Because we use the exterior core face, the wall shifts into the other direction. You need to be careful with this situation. Sometimes if you use a different face which is not the center of the core, when you want to flip, it's sometimes better to change the location, the wall location line. I'm going to undo and select this wall. Hold down the control, select this and this. Change the location line to core center line. Now click to deselect. Select the wall, flip. Now the wall flip with no problem. Do the same thing for the rest. Zoom out to see what you have done so far. Zooming into this here, right click this wall and select create similar. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Click the modify button. Select this wall and change this value to 1650 mm. Press enter. Click this arrow to flip it into the other direction. With the wall C selected, select create similar. Start a line, the line command from this point, and zoom into this area. Move the mouse cursor into 45 degree direction and click. Click the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Click the split element tool and click on this wall. Click the trim extend single element. Select the face of this wall and trim this wall. Click the modify button. Go to the navigation bar and click the zoom to fit command. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Alright, we're going to end this video. In the next tutorial, we'll continue to draw the floor plan of our project. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or suggestion, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.